And I kind of wanted to get into a little bit of the quantum mechanics that we were talking about. The video link that you put on your video was a link to that movie, What the Bleep Do We Know? And that movie's caught a lot of flack because of its, I guess you could say, its ethical treatment of the issue, because they were a little bit deceptive in how they interviewed people about this subject. And I just want to read one comment from one of the scientists that was in that movie. His name was David Albert, and he's the professor from the Columbia University Physics Department, and he was featured in this movie. And he said, quote, "I was edited in such a way as to completely suppress my actual views on the matters of the movie discusses. I am, indeed, profoundly unsympathetic to attempts at linking quantum mechanics with consciousness. Moreover, I explained all that, at great length, on camera, to the producers of the film. Had I known that I would have been so radically misrepresented in the movie, I would certainly not have agreed to be filmed." Now, this is pretty much prominent throughout that movie. They say in that movie that quantum mechanics is unexplainable. And then the theme of the movie is that they begin to explain it. And it's sort of a, they're adding their own interpretation and the things that they want to say about quantum mechanics in such an intellectually dishonest way. The people affiliated with that movie, there's a woman, her name is Ramtha, and I don't know much about her, but what I do know is that she's affiliated with The Secret. I don't know if you've ever seen that film or read the book, but it's this new age, you know, eternal consciousness, based on the misunderstandings of quantum mechanics, where they basically say that if you wish for something hard enough, you interact with the energies of the universe and you bring whatever you want into being. And it's fairly obvious that their agenda is being pushed not only through The Secret, but also through this film, What the Bleep Do We Know? Because the entire the entire motivation behind these movies is not scientific whatsoever. It's based largely on anecdotes, stories. There is no solid science behind what they do. Yes, they do cite the double-slit experiment, but the double-slit experiment does not demonstrate the micro world having an effect on the macro. Now, the point in the experiment which you explained was the part where they put a meter in between the slits to measure, you know, which slot the electron or the photons were going through. Now, what this does do is it shows how the macro, or the large world, can have an effect on the micro. But what it does not do is show that the micro has an effect on the large or the macro. And I have never seen an experiment that does show that. I'm perfectly willing to, you know, see the evidence if there is any. But I think, you know, the one point that you brought up about the flu virus, I would not consider the flu to be on the micro scale, because as with, you know, the brain, you know, the muscles and the leg, as I was talking about, viruses are made up of atoms, and you don't get to the micro world until you get to that atomic level, until you break down into subatomic particles, the quarks. And so even in the case of the flu, this is still the macro having an effect on the macro. This hasn't demonstrated any effect as far as micro affecting the macro. So I don't know. I think that's enough for now. Just some concerns I had with that movie, What the Bleep Do We Know? And I think I pretty much addressed everything that I wanted to talk about for now, but feel free to comment back if you want. I'm looking forward to hearing from you. So thanks for watching.